I am a zombie prepper. Now, when I tell people that, I usually get a lot of strange looks. Yeah, kind of like that. When I say that I'm a zombie prepper, that I'm preparing for the zombie apocalypse, I know that a lot of people might assume that maybe I'm a little bit paranoid, maybe I've got a cache of weapons somewhere, and maybe I'm not quite rooted in reality. When really, that couldn't be further from the truth. Now, don't get me wrong, with any group, there's spectrums. So there are individuals that kind of fit those assumptions. But I think you might be surprised as to how many of us there really are. You might actually be sitting next to one of us right now. Maybe. So why zombies? Well, before we answer that and go down that rabbit hole, travel back in time with me for just a moment. The year was 2005. I was just finishing up my degree at Sam Houston State University and located in Huntsville, Texas. Now, Huntsville is located just a little north of Houston, Texas. Less than 30 days ago, Hurricane Katrina had made landfall, and now Hurricane Rita threatened Houston. The mass exodus of residents out of Houston was compounded by the fear of what we saw when Hurricane Katrina made landfall. Then Hurricane Rita shifted, which caused a brand new wave of evacuees to try to escape the new path. Huntsville was one of the nexus points among both of those evacuation routes. Our little college town was completely flooded by evacuees coming north out of Houston and those heading west to escape the new path of Rita. In 2008, I wasn't so lucky, but luckier than most. I had moved further south, closer to Houston, and in 2008, Hurricane Ike struck. At this time, my wife and I had only lost power for 5 days, but only 5 days, while many other residents were out for weeks. But it was at that moment that I realized I was nowhere near prepared at all. So I started reading. I was like, what can I do in order to prepare myself for maybe the next hurricane? So I started reading the Red Cross website, FEMA, and by the next hurricane season, I was prepared. But what if the next disaster wasn't a hurricane? And down the rabbit hole I went. I started reading survival blogs and books about natural disasters and how the government might respond. But along the way, I found zombies. Now, at first, I was like, okay, this is a little bit silly. Here's all these people preparing for the zombie apocalypse. As a biologist, I thought, this is a little bit silly. It's pretty far out of the realm of reality. But then, I fell in love with zombies. I've always had a special place in my heart for horror films. I remember as a kid watching The Creature from the Black Lagoon in black and white. As I got older, it was werewolves. And werewolves just freaked me out for some reason. I can't place it, but they did. But as I got older, I ended up with the zombie. And it fit into this role of preparation. Because here's really the secret to this. If you're prepared for the zombie apocalypse, you're essentially prepared for anything. I mean, consider for a minute. A zombie replicates a biological outbreak, terrorism, or riots. The impact of a zombie apocalypse makes you consider things like blackouts or loss of utilities, things like waste management and water purification. Consider for a moment that in your city, there's a zombie outbreak. Yes, I know. Just come along with me on this one, okay? There's a zombie outbreak. How do you survive? Can you escape the zombie apocalypse? Can you get away from these zombies? And if you can, how quickly can you do it? How long would it take you to leave your home with all the things that you need? 5 minutes? 30 minutes? An hour? Do you already have bags prepared? Well, really, in the real world, what this mimics is a natural disaster evacuation. Okay, so there's parallels here. But in this scenario, let's pretend that you can't leave, that there's a quarantine, and you have to stay home. Do you have enough food and water for your family to survive for 3 days? What about 7 days? In the real world, this is something that we see in blizzards and flooding and earthquakes. These are all scenarios that you might not be able to leave your home. Maybe you're trapped for that time period. Let's say that you do have food and water. You've kind of prepared for this, right? So that's great. But now can you keep your home and your family safe from those very same zombies. Again, the real-world parallel here is something like riots or civil unrest. And if you do have to come into contact with other humans, or maybe zombies, how do you keep yourself from becoming infected? So we have to think, is this a zombie virus? Is this transmitted by a bite? Is it in the blood? Is it airborne? So do you have things to protect yourself from becoming infected? Things like surgical gloves or a surgical mask. What this can really replicate in the real world scenario are things like biological outbreaks or terrorist attacks or a flu outbreak. The point is, we have a very good chance of coming into contact with all of these scenarios in one form or another. And this is not me being paranoid. This is data from NOAA looking at climate disasters from 1990 all the way up to 2014. Also from NOAA, we can see that the climate disasters, or again, these natural disasters in 2014 across the United States, from the USGS, the activity or chances of earthquake activity across the United States. And of course, who could forget the two cold waves that we experienced in 2014? And to add to this, just last week, we had a tropical storm move to a Category 5 hurricane in 24 hours. And today, there's flooding in Central Texas. Now, I know what you're thinking. Man, this guy really is paranoid. Okay, I'll admit, I'm a little bit paranoid. I'll give that to you. But within reason, I do have data for my paranoia at least, right? This is data from 2000 to 2014 of those same disasters, those climate disasters, by state. You can see who has one of the highest ones, don't you? Texas, with 42 events. So, sure, maybe I'm a little bit paranoid, but I've got reason, right? And we haven't even talked about biological outbreaks. What about flu? We didn't even talk about that, right? But these are the things I consider as a zombie prepper. The other thing with zombies is that they are highly unpredictable. Now, you don't get that with a lot of your other movie monsters. How do you prepare for werewolves? That's pretty easy. You wait till the full moon. Grab some silver bullets first, but you wait till the full moon. That's easy, very predictable. What about vampires? Well, if they twinkle, you know who they are. Vampires, still predictable. You wait till dusk, spray on some garlic cologne, go hang out at the church, you're safe. But you don't get that with zombies. Zombies can show up at any time and any place. And when you consider this, you start asking this one question. How can I afford an island? No, not really. Yes, you do. But the idea behind this, though, is when you consider something like the zombie apocalypse, as crazy it may seem, you start thinking about things long-term. Because preparation is really about prevention. You know, we've seen hurricanes, Sandy, Ike, Katrina, earthquakes and tsunamis. And you know, after these events, one does simply not go grocery shopping after this. Okay, it's too late for that. If you don't have the supplies that you need, in a crisis, you become stressed. And we humans don't always make the best decisions when we become stressed. And sometimes those decisions are fatal. Now, apparently I wasn't the only one to consider this. In 2011, the CDC, seeing how the zombie craze was taking hold and seeing an opportunity here for that, they created a website about how to survive the zombie apocalypse. And it lists many of the things that we've already talked about here today. Their website, on the first day it went live, crashed because of all the people going to this website. So, today, I'm here to recruit you, and you can be on my zombie apocalypse team. Maybe. I want you to be prepared. You don't have to hoard food for a year or go out and buy weapons or anything crazy like that. Preparation is as simple as next time you go to the grocery store, buy a few extra goods, grab a gallon of water, and store it. Being prepared is about taking care of yourself and your family so that first responders can take care of those in the dire need first. It's about easing the burden of our men and women in the line of duty. Because if you're prepared, you don't have to be paranoid or stressed You've got everything that you need. So, go out and read. Figure out what it is that you and your family might need in these situations. Whatever that may be, go grab some stuff. Go to the Red Cross website. Go to FEMA. Look at these things. They have great lists so that you can be prepared for the next power outage or storm, or in my case, the coming zombie apocalypse. Thank you.